Hello, my name is Astrid Franz from the Philips Research Labs in Hamburg. My co-authors are Alexander Schmidt-Richberg, Elisa Orazano and Christian Lawrence. We are working together in a fetal ultrasound project and want to present you here our poster named Deep Learning-Based Spine Centerline Extraction in Fetal Ultrasound. Let me guide you through the PDF file of this poster and let's start with the abstract. Ultrasound is widely used for fetal screening. Searching for optimal ultrasound planes for growth assessment and anomaly detection is a demanding and time-consuming task. On our poster, we describe a method for automatically detecting the spine centerline in 3D fetal ultrasound images. We propose a two-stage approach, combining deep learning and classic image processing techniques. First, we segment the spine using a deep learning approach. The resulting probability map is used as input for a tracing algorithm. In this way, we get a sequence of points describing the spine centerline. This line can be used for measuring the spinal length and for generating view planes for the investigation of anomalies. Now let's go down a little bit on the poster to the introduction section to describe the background of our method. Fetal screening with ultrasound allows for detecting abnormalities at an early gestational age, such that interventions can be planned and performed as required. Currently, there is a trend towards using 3D ultrasound, since a 3D image contains much more spatial information about the location of several organs with respect to each other, and it allows for a variety of workflow optimizations. One of the main fetal scans takes place in the second trimester, with recommended standard measurements. The localization of the abdominal cross-sectional plane with the corresponding measurement of the abdominal circumference is described, for instance, in reference 2. Another structure that is investigated is the fetal spine. First, the length of the spine provides an insight into the fetal growth. Second, a variety of spinal anomalies can be detected in 3D fetal ultrasound scans. State-of-the-art fetal ultrasound examination is based on a manual search for optimal view planes, which is a demanding and time-consuming task. Hence, an automatic detection of the spine center line would be of huge benefit, since it allows for an automatic generation of view planes, which are well suited for the investigation of spinal anomalies. Now, let's go down a little bit to the materials and methods section. We used 400 3D fetal ultrasound scans with a wide range of gestational age from 15 to 41 weeks, with a mean of 26 weeks. The in-plane voxel size ranged from 0.12 to 0.51 mm with a mean of 0.25 mm, and the slice thickness was in range of 0.3 to 0.93 mm with a mean of 0.51 mm. In all these datasets, we annotated the spinal canal by manually setting 5 to 10 landmarks. These landmarks are connected by straight lines. Starting from this line, we created label masks by dilating with different radii. An example of this is shown in Figure B. In Figure A, you see an example dataset with an annotated spine centerline. And in Figure B, this blue region here is the dilated centerline, which is a label mask which we used for the deep learning approach. The so constructed label maps are used as input for deep learning approach with an FNet, as described in reference 4. The FNet is a fully convolutional network architecture that processes images at multiple scales and different fields of view. It combines detailed voxel level features with large context information. The segmentation results were nearly independent on the FNet parameters, such as kernel size and number of feature extraction blocks. Hence, we use the standard settings of 4, namely kernel size 3 and number of feature extraction blocks 3. However, we reduced the number of resolution levels from the standard settings of 4 to 3, Since the receptive field at resolution level 3 has a size of 25 cm at a gestational age of 42 weeks. This means it contains nearly the complete fetal torso. Thus, resolution level 4 would not add any more information. The result of the FNET segmentation is a probability map describing the probability of the class spine. This probability map is used as input for an iterative tracing algorithm, as described in reference 5. The tracing starts with the point having largest probability. At this point, the probability-weighted covariance matrix is computed. The eigenvector corresponding to the largest eigenvalue of this matrix is used as estimation of the tangent direction. We move in this tangent direction until a probability value of less than 0.5 or a maximal moving distance is reached. This algorithm is repeated iteratively and in both directions from our starting point. In this way, we get a sequence of spine centerline points and they are connected by line segments. For evaluating our results, we use three different evaluation metrics. The first one, the Dice coefficient, is used for evaluating the FNET segmentation. The Dice coefficient measures the overlapping region of the signet ground truth annotation and the probability map generated by the FNET. The other two measures, namely the false negative rate and the mean distance, are used to describe the resulting spine centerline. The false negative rate describes the fraction of the ground truth line which is not contained in the resulting traced spine centerline. We used a predefined outlier distance of 10 mm to define which points are found. For computing the false negative rate, both the ground truth line and the detected centerline are approximated by 100 tightly spaced points. For each of these 100 points of the detected spine centerline, which is not a false negative, the distance to the ground truth line is computed. This distance is averaged, yielding a mean distance of the detected spine centerline to the ground truth annotation. Furthermore, it needs to be mentioned that we split our dataset in 5 folds of 80 images each to perform a 5-fold cross-validation. The three evaluation metrics for a variety of dilation radii are shown on the right-hand side of the poster. The points here indicate the values for the 5 folds and the line is the mean. The Dice coefficient is increasing with growing dilation radius. This is to be expected, since the more voxels a structure has, the less a voxel mismatch will count towards the overlap. For elongated structures, this measure is not well suited for describing the segmentation accuracy. Hence, let's look at the other two measures. They show a drastic decrease when the dilation radius goes from 0 to 5, and then stay nearly constant, where the false negative rate shows a minimum at 15. For this dilation radius 15, we plotted box-whisker plots for the three measures. Clearly, the Dice coefficient is larger for training than for test, while the mean distance and the false negative rate are smaller. But these effects are not very pronounced, indicating only a slight overfitting effect. Half of the test cases have a false negative rate below 3%, meaning that in half of the test cases, at least 97% of the annotated ground truth spine line is found by our algorithm. Hence, our presented fully automatic two-stage approach for detecting the spine centerline in 3D fetal ultrasound scans yields promising results. The resulting spine centerline can be used for selecting dedicated viewplanes. They can be presented to the physician for investigating the spine, for instance, for measuring the length or detecting anomalies. An estimation of the spinal length can even automatically be proposed by calculating the length of the detected centerline. Furthermore, a flex view could be generated, showing the spine and the outgoing ribs in a straightened view for further investigation.